So in this example, we can see that here a star is mentioned. So star means, apart from this, whatever is left, that is taken for another frame. Okay. I can also mention my frame set as like this. Also, I can mention, for suppose example, I'm writing rows. I can mention like this. Okay, so 20% third frame will be 20%, rest two will be randomly divided. So star can also be used. Now let's discuss some of the frame set tag attributes. So one is columns. We have already discussed it. So it specifies how many columns are contained in the frame set and the size of each column. Okay, so you can specify the width of each column in four ways. So one way is your absolute value of the pixels. For example, for creating three vertical columns, I can mention 100, 500, 100. I can mention like this. Okay. So second way is a percentage of the browser window. Okay. Percentage of browser window. For example, to create three vertical frames, I can write 10%, 80% and 10%. So this is what we have used in our example. Okay. Then third is using a wildcard symbol. So for example, to create three vertical frames, I can write columns equal to 10% star 10%. Okay. So this star example already I have told in my just the previous example. So this star is known as a wildcard symbol, and in this example, three vertical frames are created. One is 10%, first one is 10%, third one is 10%, and remaining remainder of the window, okay, that is taken by this symbol, that is the wildcard symbol, to create a frame. Fourth is a relative width of the browser window. Okay, now what's that? Let me explain you. For example, so to create three vertical frames, I can write here columns, then equal to, I can write here okay. So this is an alternative of the percentages. So you can use the relative width of the browser window here. So here what is happening, the window is divided into 6. Okay, so the first column, so 3 4 5 6, so window is divided into 6. So the first column here, it takes up half of the window. Okay, then there is a second one is, it is taking 1/3 of the window, and the third one is taking 1/6 of the window. So these are the four various ways of mentioning the vertical frame. difference. Now, the second one is rows. This also we have used in our example. So this works just like the columns attribute, and it takes the same values, but it is used to specify the rows in the frame set. For example, I can write 10%, 90%. Okay. We can specify the height of each row in the same way as explained for columns. The same way I can explain here also. We can use the same type of declarations for rows also. Coming to the third attribute, that is your border. So this attribute specifies the width of the border of each frame in pixel. So it is used to mention the width of the border of each frame in pixels. For example, I can write border equal to 5. Okay, if I am writing border equal to 0, then this means no border. Next is the frame border. So this attribute specifies whether a three-dimensional border should be displayed between the frames or not. To specify three-dimensional border. Between your frames. Okay. So this attribute can have values either 1, which means a yes, or 0, which means a no. For example, I can write, if I am writing frame border equal to 0, so this means no border. No border means there should be no 3D border. Similarly, we have another attribute, that is your frame spacing. So this attribute, it specifies the amount of space between frames in a frame set. So this can take any integer value. For example, we can write frame spacing equal to 10, which means there should be 10 pixels spacing between each frames. Okay, so this is all about your attribute for frame set tag. So now let's discuss about frame tag attributes. Okay, we have used the frame tag, so we have used src. Okay, so it is used to give the file name that should be loaded. So it is used to mention the source file name which is to be loaded in the frame. So its value can be any URL. For example, I can write this as your suppose I have a folder images and this slash I can write suppose img1.html. So this is written, so it will load an HTML file. This is my HTML file. This will be loaded, which is available in the images directory. Okay. Similarly, we have another attribute, that is name. So this attribute allows you to give a name to a frame. Give a name to a frame. It is used to indicate which frame a document should be loaded into. This is especially important when you want to create links in one frame that load pages into another frame. Okay? That time it is mainly required. So when in that case, what happens? The second frame needs a name to identify itself as the target of the link. Okay? You are clicking a link in frame number 1, but the page has to be loaded into frame number 2. So that means the target of the link should be specified. Then third comes frame border. So this attribute specifies whether or not the borders of that frame are shown. Okay. So it overrides the value given in the frame border attribute of the frame set tag. So it overrides your frame border value of frame set tag. Okay. If the value is mentioned in the frame set tag, so and again we are mentioning it here for the frame tag, so this overrides. And it can take values either 1 or 0. These are the two possible values it can take. Next is margin width. So this attribute allows to specify the width of the space between the left and right of the frame borders and frame contents. Okay. So it allows us to specify the width of the space between the left and right of the frames, borders and the frames content. Okay, so the value is in pixels, value is given in terms of pixels. For example, I can write margin width equal to 10. Okay, this I can write. So now the next attribute is fourth. So the fifth attribute, it is your margin height. So this attribute allows to specify the height of the space between the top and bottom of the between's borders and its contours. Okay, so here also value is given in pixels. Example is, I can write margin height equal to suppose 10. Okay, so our next is no resize. So by default you can resize any frame. Okay, we can resize a frame, so this is by default. Okay, so how we can do it? We can do this by clicking and dragging on the borders of a frame. So the no resize attribute, if we are mentioning this, it prevents a user from being able to resize the frame. So no resize, it prevents from being able to resize the frame. Okay, we mention it like this, no resize, the value of no resize, so it will be preventing it. Now next is scrolling. So this attribute controls the appearance of scroll bars. You must have seen frames, they are having scroll bars of their own. So it controls the appearance of the scroll bars of the frames. So this takes values either yes or no or auto. Okay, for example, if I am writing scrolling is equal to no, then it means it should not have scroll bars. Okay, next is long description. In short, it is written long DES, des. Okay, now this attribute allows to provide a link to another page containing a long description of the contents of the frame. Okay, so for example, here we can write if long description equal to some frame, suppose I'm describing. I can write it like this. Okay, so these are the 8 attributes which are supported by the frame tag. So now if a user is using any old browser or any browser which does not support frames, then no frame element should be displayed to the user. Okay, we have already taken an example for you, no frame tag. So you can use this to display any message if my browser does not support the frame set tags. Okay, so now you know that when there are many frames, one frame may consist of a hyperlink, and on clicking of the hyperlink, the page which should be displayed, the HTML file, should be loaded into some other frames. Okay, so in those cases, what happens? We need to mention the target frame. Okay, So suppose there is a file, I mean there is a frame. This is my frame, this is my window, and already suppose this total window is divided into 3 frames. So if this consists of hyperlinks and we click on this hyperlink, so when I click on this hyperlink, so the respective page, the one should be opened here. Okay, so how that happens? So this is the frame in which a page has to be loaded. Okay, so what we do is, in this document, in this HTML file, when we are mentioning this hyper references using our href, anchor tag we are using a tag, and we are mentioning the href there itself, we need to mention an attribute target. The attribute is target. We should be writing target equal to the particular frame name. Okay, so we mention that as, so target equal to, suppose my frame name is main page. So I should be writing target equal to this one. Where I should write this one? I should be writing this inside my a tag, where I mentioned the a href, give a space, then mention the target. Okay, so this should be open. Suppose I am writing my profile, so my profile will be appearing here. When I click on it, this is the target place, this is the target place where my file will be opened. Okay, so which file has to be opened, that we mentioned here. Where it should be opened, that we mentioned here. On clicking what, we mention it here. Okay, so these types of things, examples we have already discussed. Now this target, okay, so target attribute can also take values like your underscore self, which means it will load the page into the current frame, this frame itself. It can also take values like blank, so it will be loading the page in a new browser window, opening a new window. Okay, underscore parent, so loads the page into the parent window, which in the case of a single frame set is the main browser window itself. We have underscore top, so it loads the page into the browser window replacing any current frames. Okay, or you need to mention the target frame. So here it loads the page into the targeted frame. Okay, so next, coming to HTML iframes, so it is used to display a web page within a web page. Okay, so iframe, the tag used is this one, iframe. We write it like iframe, then source equal to your URL, and then we close the tag. Okay, so this source attribute, what it does, it specifies the URL or your web address of the inline frame page. Okay. So for your iframe, we can mention the height and width. Okay. We use the attributes height and width to specify the size of the iframe. This is used to specify your iframe size. Okay, and these are in terms of pixels. For example, I can write iframe source equal to demo.htm, then height equal to suppose 200, width equal to suppose 300, and then this is the iframe. Okay, we can use CSS to set the height and width of the iframe also. So in that case, we write it as iframe sources demo.htm, then we use the style attribute as we have already used in many examples. So height I can mention as 2 pixel, then width I can mention as suppose 300 pixel, and then close the iframe tag. Okay, if I want to remove the border, by default iframe is having a border around it. If I want to remove that, so here in style I can simply add your border is none. So if I'm adding this, so iframe will not be having any border. Similarly, I can mention the color of the iframe border, I can mention the border, I can mention the width of the border. Okay, in that case we write it as border suppose 2 pixel, solid suppose I want a blue color border, so we will write solid blue. Now, iframe can be used as a target frame for a link. So the target attribute of the link must refer to the name attribute of the iframe. Okay? This we have already, told previously how to do it. So let me give you an example to just give you an example for it. For example, what I'm giving you an example? I'm giving you an example of iframe target for a link. Okay. So iframe can be used as a target frame for a link. So target attribute of the link must refer to the name attribute of the iframe. So example is suppose iframe. I am mentioning the source file name, name of the iframe I am mentioning, suppose it is iframe 1, and then I am closing my iframe tag. Okay, now in my paragraph I can have a reference anchor tag, we have already used it. Okay, suppose yahoo.com, so then we need to mention the target equal to So I'm usually writing it here itself. I'm continuing it in the next line. I framed one. Okay. And here text is my Yahoo. Then I'm ending the anchor tag and then ending the paragraph tag. So here what will happen, whenever I will be clicking on Yahoo, so this will be opening. This is the reference page which should be opened on clicking on this. But where it will be opening? It will be opening this in this iframe. Okay. So today's class we have gone through HTML iframe tag and what it is, how and when to use it. Okay. We also discussed about the frame set and frame attributes, different attributes, and how to use them. So that's all for today's class. Thank you.